hand of the king looks to be in big trouble.
There's a major war.
Poor little pig. How could it burn like that?
Good day to you, Mors. You wouldn't by any chance have some work for me there in your pouch?
It would seem that something weighs heavily upon you, Walder.
There is actually something of which I would speak to you. We must do something for Patrick, Mors. I fear for him.
Explain yourself.
Let's just say that the fellow reminds me of an old story of mine.
A story, eh?
Aye, a story of long ago, when I was a child. In another life, you could say. There was this carpenter, Fat Beron, a jolly fellow, as round as a barrel, but with magical fingers, capable of making anything. Well, this man had a bitch, a big black beast, as nice can be. She let the little ones climb on her. They tore tufts of hair from her, and not the slightest yelp of pain. She didn't even push them off.
I'm not sure I follow you, Walder.
I'm getting to it. One day, this gentle bitch goes and kills a little boy, a tiny little wretch who just slipped her some scraps of stew to eat. Shrip, just like that, she tore his throat out.
Let me guess. You believe Patrick could have gone down the same path?
Exactly. You see, the thing is that me, I'd seen the trouble coming. She'd begun changing weeks before, months even. First, she stopped wagging her tail. Then she'd flee when children came to pester her. Sometimes she'd start growling. Me, when I saw that, I refused to touch her or even to walk anywhere near her. I already knew how to sense trouble back then. The others made fun of me, treated me like a weakling and a piss pants, but I didn't give a damn. When it happened, everyone seemed so surprised. I would have been rolling with laughter if it hadn't been so tragic.
And Patrick gives you that same feeling?
Sometimes something breaks inside someone, and we see them do things that we'd never have believed possible. When I look at Patrick, when I see his eyes so cold, so empty, I remember that story. It's been a long time since that one wagged his tail as well. You know, that bitch, they had to destroy her after all that.
I understand your concerns, brother. I'll keep an eye on it.
Good day to you, Mors. You wouldn't by any chance have some work for me there in your pouch?
I haven't forgotten you, Walder.
Show me.
I have brought you the King of the Heavens, Walder.
The Father? What a fine piece. It is very well preserved. I shan't need to work on it long.
You seem very sure of yourself.
The Father judges us all. He is authority and justice. You don't believe me capable of lying to his face, do you? Never fear. I will watch over it like the tip of my nose. Good day to you, Mors. You wouldn't buy any Show me.
I have found the statuette of the smith. It has been badly damaged.
There's nothing I cannot mend. It's simply going to call for a little time. But the rewards are too good to ignore. It's an interesting challenge, especially the hammer. I wonder what I can do to restore it. Maybe with onyx. We'll see. Good day to you, Mors. You wouldn't buy any... Show me.
The White Maiden awaits your love and care, my friend.
Really? You have rarely brought me so much pleasure as you have today, Mors. Finding these hues will be a delicate matter. Almost as delicate as this beautiful face. I don't know who sculpted these statuettes, but I'm beginning to think that it's not the work of a man.
Make sure your hands remain steady and focused on the task, Walder.
Good day to you, Moors. You wouldn't... Show me.
The final traveler has completed his journey in my safe hands.
What do you mean by that, Knight?
A body which is neither that of a man nor of woman. A face which is but a smooth mask.
The stranger. We of the Night's Watch don't fear him as much as the rest of Westeros.
In the shadow of the wall, we know we already walk by his side towards the unknown. He is an old traveling companion.
Indeed. He deserves a little refreshment. I shall give him back all his mysterious darkness. Trust me. Good day to you, Moors. You wouldn't...
I have the late...
The crone? I'm starting to believe that you'll succeed in your quest, Moors. You know she represents the wisdom of the ancients, don't you? Those who have the experience to guide us through the trials of the night.
For the moment, in my eyes, she represents the weight of my ancestors.
You'll accomplish this quest, Moors Westford. I feel it in my old bones. There, they're finally together again. It's incredible. If you'd asked me, I wouldn't have wagered on it.
Do you have all you need now?
Yes, but just give me a moment. Come in, warm yourself up a little. Admire this work. Isn't it magnificent? I can honestly say I have never created anything so beautiful.
Indeed. You've been true to your word, brother. And I mine. I won't forget it.
Honor the Seven and thank them for their blessings. Your vow to them has been fulfilled. I'm certain there's a good reason for that. Your soul is in safe hands, Morse. Be assured of it.
Thank you for everything, Walder. At last, they are together again. My ancestor's vow has been fulfilled. Do you know what this means, Alistair?
I know, Morse. The promise has passed through blood from father to son for almost 3 centuries.
It was a miracle finding each piece after all these years. Godly intervention.
You place your faith in pitiful lies, my friend. There is but one God. He's the one offering you this chance to discover him.
What?
Think about it, Moors. What have the Seven brought you? The death of your family, the end of your name, injustice. These pathetic idols represent all that has blackened your heart, everything you should reject. Your misfortunes stem from your previous deeds, blinded as you were by your false religion.
I am not doing it for me, brother, but for my ancestors and my family's honor.
So do what must be truly done. This past is dead. All that remains is for you to light its funeral pyre. You had the right of it to believe that finding all these idols was godly intervention. It's a sign from R'hllor, who now expects an act of faith from us.
What are you trying to say to me?
Crush them and burn their remains together. You have tasted the fire of R'hllor. You know that he is the one true God. Let us pay homage together, and let us cast out these false gods who have led both our families to ruin.
I have taken an oath, Alistair.
You swore to bring together all 7 of these false idols, to find all the idols of the past. Now they belong to you. It is for you, and you alone, to decide what should be done.
You have the right of it. Let the gods decide between them. Let us see if your fire is stronger than these bits of rock.
Thank you, my friend. You cannot imagine how proud I am of you. Let us proceed with the cleansing.
Lots of new brothers. By the old gods, Mors, what have you done? A woman in the Night's Watch. What were you thinking? I had so much faith in you. Ah, Mors, you've come back to us. You did well to bring Andar. He's a good man, and certainly did not deserve to be beheaded for his one brief fit of panic. I'm still not sure what to do with the boy from Molestown, but I suppose he's an extra pair of hands. This man you brought back from the Westerlands is one of the best swordsmen I have ever seen. He would even make an excellent master of arms if Endru Tarth were unable to replace Alistair Thorne in that position. I see you brought back some scum from Riverspring. I suppose it's a welcome change from the capital scum. That poor man who lost his family during the plundering of the city seems very frail to me. He'll have to adjust quickly if he wants to survive his training. And the winter.
So, Adam Flowers was in charge of this infamous patrol. And of all those who took part, only Watt is still alive.
We should try and find out more about Flowers.
You're right. Let's go search his chest.
Rounding up his armies.
So, our Adam might not be so innocent.
This letter suggests he performed the sacrifice himself 4 years ago.
Aye. That's very different to the version of events given in the patrol's report. I need to question him as soon as possible. Duncan, do you know where I can find Adam?
Ice and darkness. Watt is the only member of the patrol still alive. Flowers is probably finishing off his last victim.
Adam's got him exactly where he wants him. Damn it all. We need to find them immediately.
So, Mors, are we gonna save his wildling girl?
Patrick has nothing to do with these crimes, and he'll be cleared. Do you have a problem with that?
Well, yes, in that we have a problem with that.
We don't want him with us. That son of a bitch takes sick pleasure in killing us one by one.
We won't let you carry on with your little investigation, Mors. You need to stop it right now, else we'll stop you.
Adam Flowers is behind all these murders. More of your brothers will soon be dead unless we find him quickly.
Flowers? He's the one that ripped out their hearts.
I just don't believe it!
It is true, whether you believe it or not.
The warrior's balls. Well, in that case, I suppose we won't stop you.
A wise decision.
That son of a bitch.
Are you happy now? Here are your cursed hearts. They're yours. White Walkers. I hope you savor them. Mors, there you are at last. And you've brought your friend. That's good. You were all that was missing.
Adam, we know that you're the one killing our brothers and stealing their hearts.
The bastards were trying to blackmail me. I still don't know which one of them it was, but it no longer matters. I got them all.
Are you insane, Adam? Give it up. You're trapped. You cannot hope to escape.
I'm not alone, Mors. They talk to me. Ever since that day, the wildlings forced me to eat poor Argilac's heart. The White Walkers! They want more sacrifices! Always have and always will!
No one is talking to you, Adam. You've simply lost your mind. And now you will die for all the crimes you have committed.
Feel free to try, but they won't let me die!
So, the madman sent his old patrol to the grave.
Few people could have lived after what he went through.
I was unaware how powerful the forces were beyond the wall. The White Walkers are clear enemies of the Lord of Light.
And both nothing more than ghosts in someone's imagination.
You're not one to talk of ghosts, Mors.
I can't argue with that.
Thank you.
found Adam. He was the one behind all these murders.
It's hard to believe.
It all goes back to a patrol 3 years ago, when he said he escaped the wildlings. However, he didn't really escape. The wildlings agreed to let him go, after he ate the heart of the sworn brother they captured alongside him.
No, Jess. That's disgusting. I can't even imagine.
He thought he'd left all of it in the past, but someone knew his secret and had started blackmailing him. He was certain that it could only be one of the original patrol, so he began killing them off, one by one. The same vile way he killed the first of his brothers.
How could he do such a thing?
He'd lost his mind. When I found him in the forest, he talked of hearing voices and white walkers.
And what?
He was already dead when I reached Adam. There was nothing I could do to save him.
Seven hells.
However, that monster is now dead. So we have no reason to be holding Patrick prisoner anymore.
Agreed. We'll release him right away, as soon as we inform the Lord Commander about what happened.
Thank you, Morse. Thank you with all my heart.
Now you'll be able to resume your watch.
Yes, I suppose. But to be honest, I'm unsure how I feel. My brothers were so quick to turn their backs on me. For many, I was never really one of them.
You're a sworn brother of the Night's Watch, Patrick. No one can deny that.
I suppose you're right.
Has another daughter.
Is it true?
Damn wildlings.
Finally home. May the others take me. Mors, your face. What happened to you?
It's a long story, Halfhand. I will tell it another time if you don't mind. I'd rather you tell me how things are going here.
You did receive my message, didn't you? After the Gorn tribe fled in a panic, our builder brothers went to Icemark to seal up the door. Another band of wildlings had managed to get to the south of the wall and to hide themselves where they were working. The wildlings attacked in force. I was there to protect our brothers, but things didn't go well. It was impossible to catch them. They would come upon a man alone, tear out his heart and disappear into the forest in a blink of an eye. There was nothing we could do.
You were responsible for the repairs, Quarren. The security of our builder brothers came first. Is the work complete?
Yes. The doors are safely shut. Well, I wish those wildlings luck trying to open them up again.
That is a good thing. We can ill afford a gaping hole in the wall. What became of the wildlings?
They're still out there. Once our brothers had safely returned to Castle Black, I took my rangers back to Icemark, but the wildlings didn't wait for us to return. We need you, Mors. Help me find them before they can cause any more damage.
What did your trackers say? Do they have any idea where I should start searching?
The wildlings avoid Castle Black like the plague, that's for sure. But they seem to be heading towards Molestown.
That's unfortunate. It's best if the villagers barricade themselves in their tunnels for a while.
Could you go there, Mors? If wildlings even left the slightest trace, I know you would be able to find it. Drive the fear of the Butcher into their hearts.
I'll see to it, Halfhand. If they're in Molestown, I'll find them.
Thank you, my friend. And watch out for yourself. Remember that these wildlings know how to get by unnoticed. I would not like you to fall into a trap that was meant for me.
If that's the case, I will make them regret that they didn't look more closely at me. So long, Ranger.